You can now get a 30-day trial to experience The Athletic for free. Visit the link in the description below to try it now. By the time September rolls around, there's an early title up for grabs, the winner of the transfer window. And while other clubs may have signed higher profile players, there's little doubt that Crystal Palace can be hugely pleased with their business. A series of astute moves, augmenting the coaching hire of Patrick Vieira, have created a real buzz around the club. So, what exactly have Palace done differently? Well, the conditions were right for Palace to make significant changes this summer. The financial realities of the pandemic and Palace's own situation meant that a change in tack was required. Palace have one of the lowest revenues in the league, as detailed by The Athletic's Matt Woosnam in a recent piece. They made a loss of £61.1 million in the 13 months up to July 31st, 2020. Palace haven't made significant money on a transfer since the sale of Aaron Wan-Bissaka to Manchester United. In fact, over the last decade, including Wan-Bissaka, they've sold just 5 players for fees of £10 million or more. And that's a rather troubling statistic at a time when, for clubs outside of the top 6, sustainability is key to progress. Selhurst Park's restrictions have also meant that Palace's matchday revenue is the 6th lowest in the Premier League, and while commercial revenue has increased slightly, they are far from being in the league's top earners in that field. In fact, in the last financial results to be unaffected by the pandemic, they placed between Wolverhampton Wanderers and Southampton. In addition, Palace's position in the league, or rather their aim of maintaining Premier League status, came at a cost. Older, experienced players can bring stability on low transfer fees, but they also carry hefty wage bills and little prospect of a return on investment. Palace's most recent accounts showed a wages-to-turnover ratio of 93%, up from an already troubling 77%. Now, Palace needed those older heads, some of whom were successfully brought in under Sam Allardyce in the club's last big spending spree in January 2017. But with a raft of contracts expiring this summer, freeing up wage budget and affording the opportunity for a refresh, Palace have been able to change tack. And lastly, Roy Hodgson has departed. Hodgson deserves credit for bringing stability to the side and building the foundations for Palace's new direction, but while his preference for experience and age, as well as his conservative style, made sense, Vieira can bring a new impetus. His focus on a more attacking 4-3-3, with a holding midfielder behind two advanced eights playing out from the back, he's come at just the right time for Palace's transition. And much of this transition is based on smart recruitment. The use of data is now widespread in top-flight football, and it's not necessarily difficult to identify good players, but getting buy-in from the levels of the club that sign off on deals can be difficult. However, Dougie Friedman appears to have the latitude to shape the club's playing staff along younger, brighter lines now. The acquisitions of Eberechi Eze and Michel Olise, two of the Championship's most exciting players over the last two seasons, herald this most obviously. But look too at the signing last window of the hugely promising Nathan Ferguson, and this year the highly rated Chelsea youngsters Mark Gehi and on-loan Conor Gallagher, 24-year-old striker Jean-Philippe Mateta, and Danish international centre-back Joachim Andersen from Lyon. In the outgoing column, 11 players have been released, including big earners like Gary Cahill, James McCarthy, Andros Townsend and Mamadou Sakho. That freed up around £500,000 per week in wages, and while a good portion of this will have been spent again with a new raft of signings, there's a clear value in buying players with their peak years ahead of them, not behind. This shift makes economic sense as well as footballing sense, and this is because Crystal Palace are combining the transfer policy shift with a renewed emphasis on youth development. They have one of the most productive catchment areas in youth football and a strongly developing under-18s cohort. Last season, the club achieved Category 1 Academy status, and the club has invested £20 million in state-of-the-art facilities. Tyrick Mitchell has already made the successful jump to the first team and looks hugely promising as an attacking left-back. Wide attacker Jezuren Rucksacki is expected to be the next player off the production line, but he's not alone, with central midfielder Jack Wells-Morrison also catching the eye in pre-season. It's a shift that's not been lost on Palace fans, too. For a club that seems to take particular pride in its youth products, especially club talisman Wilfried Zaha, the change in direction has been welcomed and has engendered a real sense of optimism. Fans recognise that Hodgson's more prosaic approach built the platform, but Vieira is seen as the man to take Palace forwards. He's being given the tools to refashion the squad, younger, more dynamic, more attacking. In truth, Crystal Palace are just doing what any club in their position should: pruning the wage bill, shifting older players, and replacing them with prospects, and emphasising youth development. £20 million of investment in an academy can be recouped with one sale, after all. But Palace have seized their opportunity, with the confluence of contracts ending, the economic realities of the pandemic, and the opportunity to put the owner's money into the academy system. Many clubs talk about being smart, but Palace are actually doing it. If you like this video, please consider subscribing to the channel. The Athletic brings you the best sports journalism in the world in a personalised experience, connecting you with the stories and teams that you care about the most. There's coverage of 13 sports, plus direct access to world-class journalists through live Q&As, discussions, and podcasts. Not to mention, it's all ad-free. And you can try it now for free for 30 days by clicking the link in the description.